ITD family, welcome to vlog one of quarantine. Now, I'm currently driving around in the beautiful city of Edmonton, Alberta, out here in Canada. Now, with the whole COVID situation, this is probably gonna be known as one of the weirdest times in history. All schools are canceled, businesses are shut down, and all sports are canceled as well. So, this has led us into severe isolation. And with any sort of isolation comes a lot of discomfort. But the way I'm really trying to approach this is any sort of discomfort is an opportunity for growth. And that's exactly why I decided to share a lot of the things that I'm gonna be doing through these vlogs. I've had the privilege of having partnership deals with Two Times U, ARC, Pivotal Physio, Elite Athlete Training Systems, and I'm currently a sponsored athlete and partner with Pure Vital Labs as well. So I know these things are somewhat exciting to a younger generation audience and maybe even some of the older guys, because these are things that are not easy to do always, but definitely something that people want to be able to do. And if you guys have questions on it, I would love to share insight or maybe some intel on how I kind of went about approaching these things. Another reason why I wanted to start this is because I really wanted to share parts of me that most people don't know about. I tend to offer a lot of value, but I don't really share my personality or who I am as a person. And a lot of my friends tell me all the time that I'm always a different guy when it comes to Instagram versus the guy that they see in person. So I'm trying to be more me when it comes to being able to share these vlogs with you guys. What these are gonna include are gonna be a workout, a dribbling workout or some sort of workout. I'll probably be showing some of the athletes that I'm working with. I'm currently working with Sabri and Ahir, who are two locals who are playing Division I basketball. And it'll have a drill, maybe some nutrition, but a lot of it is gonna be based off of what you guys also want out of this. So one of the biggest things that I feel as we get into the message side of this whole portion is I've always looked at everything that I do as an opportunity to inspire. I once read this quote by Nipsey Hussle where he said that the greatest human act is to inspire. And the moment I heard that, I really did believe it, because if you think about me trying to inspire any of you guys that are watching right now, as long as I inspire one person, that really means that if you go on to inspire multiple people, I was a part of that process. And to me, I feel like that's what life is really about. It's not always about us and what we're doing. What we're trying to achieve, sure, it's very, it looks nice, it's cool, like people want to do it. But ultimately, what I want to get out of this all is for me to be able to inspire next generations and people to feel like I had an impact on them, which would allow them to kind of have that domino effect going forward as well. So that's what a lot of this vlog series is going to be about. Is I'm going to be sharing key insights of how my brain really works, why I do things the way I do it, and obviously like what I'm currently doing in terms of business, branding, Instagram, partnerships and workouts and whatnot. So we're in for some fun. And obviously you guys know I like doing things different and things at a different level, because otherwise we would not be in a car right now. And to show you what this actually looks like on your end, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. This is what's currently being done. So if you guys appreciate the effort, I go above and beyond to try to give you guys different ways to really interact with content and even find value and have it really stick. I feel like a lot of things are like catalysts. A lot of people are trying to get the same message across, but for some reason, some things are just gonna click for some people more than others. And I'm hoping to be that person for you guys. So welcome to the series and let's get it started. Right now, I'm about to train Ahir and Sabri. These guys are two locals from Edmonton, Alberta, who are currently playing Division I basketball in the States. Now, that's almost every kid's dream growing up, but there's a lot of work that it takes to kind of get to that level and even maintain to be able to stay at that level. So what I love about Ahir and Sabri is they're always finding ways to get better. They were robbed of probably the best part of the season, which is the March Madness tournament. So obviously with this whole time off, they're trying to look for ways to get better during this time, and I'm super grateful and happy to be able to show them some of the things that I've learned through the whole I'm Possible team and Micah Lancaster down in Michigan. So we're about to do a virtual training Zoom session. I can't wait to show you guys glimpses of it, and let's get it. You guys have it on a... Every time I see a snap from Sap or from here, it's always him tagged in some 2K. So basically, what I'm gonna explain today is like footwork that a lot of NBA guys use and a lot of like high-level athletes use it efficiently, like James Harden, Kevin Durant, these guys. But at the lower levels, like it's not found nearly as much. Now you have that triple extension. Everything that you guys use in basketball, triple extension. You're jumping higher, you're able to actually push because your hips, knees, and ankles are all working together. Once you guys figure this out, it's gonna open up so much more driving lanes for you guys to even get to the basket, especially because you guys are so explosive and athletic already.
That's gonna be a key, man. I needed that. Killed that jungle.
Yeah? It was good?
Yeah, you should do more of these, man.
Huh?
Right. Do more of them, man.
All right, so I just finished training Ahir and Sabri, and that was dope. It was so much fun. I don't know why it gets me so hyped up every single time. Obviously training and getting someone better is already a great feeling within itself. But when you have such high level athletes like Ahir and Sabri, to be able to take them to a further level up is a much more rewarding feeling for me personally. Although every player I train that I make better is rewarding, it just makes me feel like I'm good at my job when I'm able to take someone of that level a step further. So if you guys are interested in Zoom training sessions, please message me on Instagram, or I'll leave a link in the description below where you guys can subscribe to a newsletter and all that jazz to be able to sign up and do all those things. Other than that, I'm about to go run 5K, which I haven't done in a while, but my goal is to run 5K at least 3 times a week. We'll see how that goes, and I'm off. What's going on, YouTube? It is Friday, and honestly every day feels like Friday in this quarantine. I just got my PVL amino acids. Definitely taking those a few hours before my workout, because then it helps preserve muscle, and especially during this time when we don't have access to a gym easily, that is something that a lot of people are fearful of. So if you guys are in need of amino acids, anything supplement wise, check out PVL. I have a discount code which is Sultan20, and I'll leave a link of everything in the description below. Other than that, I'm about to hopefully go for another run. 5K yesterday was not easy, was not fun, but definitely trying to improve my time again today. It is 4:53, and I'm about to hop on a business call with Susan, who's a local here as well. She does a lot of business stuff and helps entrepreneurs figure out like the right direction towards their business. And I have a lot of different goals. I don't know if you guys have seen, I've kind of been all over the place, but now I'm really starting to condense it down and focus all my energy on just like a few things at a time. But yeah, about to hop on this call real quick for an hour. Might show you guys a glimpse of it, and then might do a ball handling workout too for about 10 minutes, something that can improve your ball handling within a short frame of time, but very detailed. And yeah, we'll go from there. I'll see you guys at the meeting. Waiting to get a phone call back. Isn't it funny? Every time you cough now, people are like, do you got the corona? It's not funny, but it's kind of funny.
What's the deal? All right. Did you get my email to set up curiosity?
I did, yeah. Quick shout out before I start this. Shout out to Sabri, man. This guy is nice. out here working on his handle. You guys get it in too. All right, so I just wrapped up the meeting. It took about 2 hours, a little bit longer than what I was expecting, but definitely needed for me to kind of take the next steps towards my business. But now let's get into some ball handling. So what I'm gonna be using is the footwork mat to hold myself accountable for width. You guys can use whatever you guys want. But essentially, I'm gonna have a really wide base, focus on being able to shift my weight from leg to leg. And what I'm gonna be doing is crossing the ball over, going through, and allowing the ball to float as I bring it back in front. Now, one of the key things when doing ball handling is, for me, what I teach players is to play with pace. I don't want you guys to just be going back and forth, back and forth. The pace should actually sound similar to this. So the periods in between is when the ball is floating. You're gonna go across, you're gonna cross over, go through, allow the ball to float and bring that ball back forward and reset back into it. And just continuously rep that out for 5 minutes going one way, switch it over going 5 minutes the other way. I'll show you guys what it looks like. Wide base, crossing over, going through, allowing the ball to float, and then getting right back into it. Now these two dribbles have to be the fastest. After you get from here to here, I wanna see if you guys have the control to be able to float the ball and the poise to bring it back forward without really messing up that dribble. Going from here is almost easier sometimes, but to go from here, float it, that's what allows you to kind of have that shiftiness too. So as we're doing this, I'll give you guys some demos. All right, so that's the drill. Simple cross through with a little float dribble. Do 5 minutes going left, 5 minutes going right. Let me know what you guys think of it. And remember that even 10 minutes of doing something so simple with that level of detail can make you a much better player and make the drill much more challenging when it is that detailed. So we're gonna continue on adding different levels of detail. Let me know what you guys think of this. Let me know if you guys try it out, tag me on Instagram and I'll definitely repost it at It's K Sultan. Probably put it up. Oh, I'm so YouTube-ish now. Put it up right here. I probably won't. I probably will. I did, didn't I? Okay, right here. Okay, what? Day two of 5K is definitely much easier than day one. This is no joke. And look at the weather. Changes from sunny to hella cloudy and rainy in just one day.
ITD family, this is probably like the third time I've watched this trailer, but I'm currently waiting for the MJ documentary to be released, just like everyone else. The best part of quarantine. But you guys have officially made it to the end of the vlog. Now, if you guys liked it, please hit the thumbs up, please subscribe, and please help the channel grow. I recently have been putting more effort into it, especially because we are now into quarantine. And obviously this is something that I want to be doing long term as well. So every like, every comment, every share, all of that stuff helps more than you guys think. And it would mean a lot to me. So I appreciate you guys. I also want some real feedback. Like if you guys didn't like something, did like something, please just let me know and I'll try to accommodate and maybe even create specific workouts for you guys according to your guys' suggestions. But other than that, thanks for tuning in to episode 1 of the vlog. And I will see you guys next time.